Hello chess lovers, welcome to our channel Chess Journey. Today we will see an interesting game between Mikhail Tal and Mac Mazurin played in the year 1974. Mikhail Tal played very tactical game and sacrificed his whole rook to win this game. We will see the combination and pattern and learn something new about the key patterns in this type of positions against d4 structures with white. So after c4, e6, knight to c3, bishop b4, knight to f3, white is controlling the center with the help of knight. This knight are looking out the central squares. So d5 instantly and d4. So basically these are d4 positions played several times. Knight to e7 and now e3. Here black has some issues developing his light square bishop, and white's light square bishop has some good squares to play. So we will see the fight to gain some momentum, how black develops his knight square bishop. c5 and now bishop to d3, knight to c6, castles. Black finishes his development with the move knight to c6, but there are some problems, practical problems related to light square bishop and castle. So now first d into c4, bishop into c4 and now castles. The position is equal right now, and if black gets slower to develop his light square bishop to good square, white will easily get the initiative to attack on the king side of the black. So a3 and now c into d4. Here the good move is a into b4, because after d into c3, b into c3, white's dark square bishop can go to a3. So there are two squares which are good, and also has bishop pair against this knight bishop ending. So but here Mikhail Tal took e into d4, and after b into c3 and now b6, here white's dark square bishop is undeveloped, but he is watching towards the king of the black, and now this knights are really not doing something much. So queen to d3. White is trying to connect these rooks after playing his dark square bishop to g5 or f1, and now bishop to b7, rook to e1. Guys, here Mikhail Tal played rook to e1, but he missed a very beautiful and winning move. Can you find it? Of course, knight to g5 to watch out at h7 mate. And there are no very good moves for black to save this mate, because after knight to g6, instantly h4 attacking this knight, and if black tries to attack with the move of h6 to attack this knight, can you find the best move in this position? Tactical move, of course. Knight to e6, f into e6, and queen into g6, and now this diagonal is weak. bishop can go to d3 and can deliver checkmate. So Mikhail Tal played rook to e1 here, and also black played h6 to stop this knight g5 idea, to sacrifice on e6 or to watch out this light square. Bishop a2, the purpose of bishop a2 is knight can play a5 to attack this c4 bishop. Well, bishop also can attack this f3 knight. Rook e8, and it is a big blunder by black. Here Mikhail Tal played very interesting move and finished the game almost for black. Can you find the move? Yes, it is a rook sacrifice. It is a whole rook sacrifice. Rook into e6, boom. And after f into e6, bishop into e6 check, and if black plays king to h8, and now a beautiful move, knight to g5, threatening this checkmate, also threatening this knight check to take this d8 queen. And you, if you take this, then this bishop is watching these squares, and this queen will suddenly jump to h3 to deliver checkmate, and it is a checkmate. So black can't take this knight. That's why black played king to f8, and now a very strong move. There are a lot of moves here, knight to h4, or but the stronger move was queen to h7, threatening this check. Mikhail Tal played here knight to h4, which is also a strong move, and you just can't play knight to d5 to play this knight to f6, because knight to g6 is a checkmate. Black king doesn't have good squares to go out. So knight to e5, and you just can't take this knight because of queen into d3, it will be blunder. So Mikhail Tal found this queen h7 idea, and here almost black's position is collapsed, and black is ready to resign, but he played some knight c6, and now you can see the rest of the game, how Mikhail Tal finished the game. This move knight to c2 is a very good move, because knight is looking this even square after rook to e8, and now black can't checkmate because this knight is guarding this even square. So and now black's king is in trouble, and black has 3 pawns, white has 5 pawns, and this position is winning for white. C4, and here black resigned the game. So a beautiful sacrifice by black on e6 by white on e6, and black resigned here. I hope you guys enjoyed this game. Please subscribe our channel Chess Journey. Thank you so much.